Hi Limansa.
Hey Chanchal.
So do you have any topic in your mind for this physics exhibition?
Yeah, I was thinking about, you know, taking something that we use the most these days.
Oh wait, I can see you wearing these cool headphones. We can take this as our topic, right?
Yeah, it will be a great topic.
Okay, let's invite our friends and discuss physics involved in these headphones.
Yeah, we should definitely invite them.
Compared to smartphones, laptops and other electronics, headphones may seem like a pretty basic technology, but in reality, a lot of advanced physics and engineering goes on behind your cans when playing your favorite beats. To give you a better grasp of the ins and outs of an essential music accessory, we have got you covered with a breakdown of how these gadgets actually operate. If you crack upon the enclosure of just about any headphone, you will find similarly designed components across the board. For starters, you first should know their major components. While different manufacturers may have additional parts inside your headphone, the following three components are standard in all models as they make up the bare bones. First is diaphragm. Inside the headphone enclosure is this little guy. It's called the driver assembly and where all the magic happens. Now the part that produces sound is also diaphragm. On speakers, it's most commonly known as core. Now the diaphragm is vibrated, or more correctly pulled back and forth at rapid succession, which pushes on the air surrounding the headphones. Disruptions and displacement in air create sound waves. Now sound waves are receptive by our ear and interpreted or perceptive by our brains. Also, in simple terms, we can say that vibrations are created on the diaphragm, causing it to move up and down and fracture the air, create the sound waves and frequencies that correspond to your audio file. Now, if we remove the diaphragm from the assembly, we will find two crucial parts that my friend is going to explain.
At the heart of your headphones is a magnet which houses a thin piece of copper called a voice coil. When you plug your headphones into an electrical source like your phone or computer, a current is pumped into the voice coil, creating a magnetic field. The role of magnet is to produce a permanent magnetic field that will attract and repulse the electrically charged diaphragm or the conductor controlling the diaphragm. Every song, video, etc. that you play through your headphones has its own audio signal that emits a varying electrical current. This current then pumps into the coil and moves it up and down inside the magnetic housing. Now coming towards voice coil. It's usually a threaded copper wire, as you can see in the image. The current directly goes from headphone jack into this concentrated voice coil, and as a result, it creates an electromagnetic field. Varying current of the audio signal causes the voice coil to move up and down alongside, or rather inside, the magnetic housing, and since it's attached to the diaphragm, it pulls the diaphragm back and forth. These three components are all housed inside what is called the driver assembly, and they are main parts responsible for creating sound.
Amplification and sound quality. Amplification is another part of how headphones work, and whether they are open back or closed back makes a big difference. Open back headphones allow for more air to enter the diaphragm and create a high quality and crisp sound. These headphones are often used in recording studios, but the downside is that the open casing allows sound to escape and ambient noise to penetrate. Closed back headphones, on the other hand, are often paired with noise cancelling earpads to completely prevent sound from leaking out of your headphones or ambient noise from muffling out your audio. The trade-off here is less amplification but a more immersive sound experience. In ear headphones, there are small speakers that direct most of the sound waves into the ear canal, while the over-ear headphones create more movement and vibration, which translates into more bass and louder sound over a larger area. The electronic signals from the MP3 file travel through the wires and are converted into sound energy with a small magnet in the speakers. These speakers will vary in size and strength depending on the quality of the magnet and the components that are attached to the magnet, like the diaphragm or cone. Most of the time, these speakers are put into boxes that amplify the sound in a certain direction or magnitude, which is how the size or shape of the headphones come to be.
The dawn of wearable headphones. Don't we all wonder that where exactly did all this begin? who invented headphones and how they improved with time. I'm here to clear all these doubts. The first headphones we would recognize as such were the invention of an American named Nathaniel Baldwin. These were called the radio headsets. Baldwin's device sat comfortably on the head with two ear cups that were connected by a headband in a design that headphones have maintained its basic form up to this day. The sound it produced was mono but decent. Like many other ambitious inventors at that time, Baldwin sent a prototype of his headphones to the US Navy, who already used similar, though clunkier and inferior systems for radio communication. The Navy was eager to order many more, only to learn that Baldwin's production was confined to run at least 10 headsets at a time, as he was producing them in his kitchen. On top of these production limitations, the young engineer and inventor refused to patent his design, believing that the innovation involved was too small to warrant it. This led to many other successful copies and contributed to Baldwin's financial ruin.